Hello, lovely great students. Welcome to another mathematics lesson. Today is November 22nd, 2020, and the value of the month remains kindness. And I hope you all have been showing kindness to people, that you've been kind to people, you've been showing love to people. Okay, let's continue to spread love and to continue this way. Last week, Thursday, we discussed about multiplication table, and I showed you different ways of doing multiplication. And I hope you did your activity, you did your homework. Today's lesson is on equalities and inequalities. And this will be done on page 80 and page 81. Here is a short video about this lesson, and this will be found on the PowerPoint that we sent along with this video, so you can watch this video on the PowerPoint. I don't want to play it now, so it won't take much of our time. And here is the objective of this lesson. The objective is to solve simple open equations containing equalities and inequalities. So we are solving some questions that has to do with equalities and inequalities. And here are the vocabulary words. The first one is equal to. What was this word is equal to? It describes the equality between the values or equations or expressions written on both sides. Okay, like we have two numbers. The equality equal to means they are both equal to each other. Like we have 6 and 6. So they are equal. They are the same numbers. They have the same value. So here we have is less than. So the word is less than in mathematical written. The less than sign is typically placed between two values being compared and signifies that the first number is less than the second number. So when you say is less than, it means that a particular number is smaller, smaller than the other number. So the next one is greater than. Greater than is used when a quantity or number is bigger or larger than the second or the rest quantities or numbers. So like I said, less than means when a number is smaller than the other number. So we say it is less than that particular number. And for greater than, it means that when a number is bigger than the other number. So we say it is greater than, bigger than, or larger than the numbers. And here is what I have. Like what I have greater than, I have equal to, and I have less than. So we'll be using this for the signs. Okay, so this will help you to understand this lesson better. So I like using this for my students. It helps them to solve these equalities and inequalities questions easily. It's better to use this so students will have a clear knowledge about this lesson, this topic. So we have greater than, it's like this. So 8 is greater than 3. 8 is greater than 3, it means it's bigger than 3. You can see where the alligator mouth is, crazy. 8 is, the alligator wants to eat the bigger number because it's more matured. It's more bigger, so it wants to eat the bigger number. The alligator always eat that bigger number. So we have 8 here, then we have 3. So which number is bigger? 8 is bigger than 3. So equal to means they have the same value, same number. So 8 and 5 and 5. So 5 is equal to 5. They are the same number, so they are equal. We have less than, okay? Less than, like I told you, that the alligator eats the bigger number. So we have 3 and 8. So which number is bigger? So like I told you, the alligator always eats the bigger number. So it faces that bigger number, the larger number. So 3 is less than 8 because 8 is greater than 3. So that's how to solve that. So I hit the bigger number. Like I told you, the alligator eats the bigger number. So it's greater than 5 is greater than 2. So the alligator eats the bigger number, which is 5. Okay? Here we have is less than. So it's always facing like this. When it's less than, so the alligator eats the bigger number. So we have 2 and we have 6. So which number is greater? So 2 is less than 6, and 6 is greater than 2. So is equal to means when, like I told you, when the number has, when two, two numbers have the same value. So we have 3 and 3. So they are the same numbers, so they are equal to each other. 3 is equal to 3. So like we have here, we use the symbols greater than, less than. We use the less than, greater than, and equal to compare numbers. So this means equal to, this means less than, and this means greater than. Okay, so like I want you to put it at the back of your mind that the alligator always eats the bigger number, so it faces the bigger number always. So here we have 3 and we have 5. Okay, 3 and 5. 3 and 5 is equal to what? 8. So we have 3 up and we have 5. So one, they are not balanced. So we put all together, we have 8. So we have 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. 8 and we have 8. So they are equal to each other. So they are balanced. We have 8 bricks here and we have 8 bricks. So you can see that it is balanced because they are the same number. They have the same value, same number. So they are equal. So it's balanced here. So here, let's see. When you have numbers like this, okay, we have 3 plus 5 and we have 7. So they say 3 plus 5 is greater than 7. Okay, so for us to know what the number here is, so we have to add this together and write the number here. I told my student to always do this. So we have 3 plus 5. So 5 plus 3. 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have 8 here. So that means that 8 is actually bigger than 7. That's why the weight here is bigger, so it's coming down. Because this is big and this is less. So the load is heavy here. It's heavy here, that's why it comes down and that's it's a bit up. So here we have 3 plus 5. Okay, and we can say that this is space, like actually the alligator always is a bigger number. So the bigger number is this. So that means this number is less. 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. I can get here. Let's move on. So here, like I told you, that the classwork will be on page 80 and the homework will be on 81. So here, like I did there, when you have numbers like this, equations like this, make sure you solve the answer. We have addition or even if it's subtraction, try to solve the answer, write it off for you to know which number should the alligator eat first. So here we have 4 plus 9. 4 plus 9, you have to solve this. 9 plus 4, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 13. So which is bigger between these two numbers? So you should know that the alligator will eat that what? That 15, which is bigger. So it eats the bigger number. So we have 12 minus 6, 12 minus 6. So which number is smaller here? When you solve this, what is the answer? You have to write the answer here. So 12 minus 6, you count from 6 to 12, or you count back from 12 to 6. You get 6 when you do this. And when you do that, so here I'm going to count from 6 to 12. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. When you count the numbers, what do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's the answer. So which number is bigger? This is bigger. So that's why it's facing here. So 6 is greater than 4. Like I told you, it follows the bigger number. So here we have 7 plus 6. What is 7 plus 6? You have to solve it, write the answer here, and you do this. So when I did this, then on that app, I noticed that the numbers, the answer here is the same as the number we have here. So that means what? They are equal to each other. They have the same number, they have the same value. So 13 and 13, so they are equal to each other. So that's how to get that. So for the next one here, I have 13 minus 4. 13 minus 4, so you take 4 away from 13. So I'll count on from 4 to 13. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I'll count this. So I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So my answer here is 9. The number here is 9. So we have 9 and we have 11. Which number is bigger? Which number is bigger here? We know that 11 is bigger than 9. So where is the alligator going to face? The alligator is going to eat the bigger number, which is 11. So it's facing. So this, that's how we solve this. Let's move on to the next one. Here we are asked to write the pairs of calculation that are equal to each other. So look at these numbers here, like they did here. 5 plus 7 is equal to 6 plus 6. So when we solve this, we add this together, they are equal to each other. So here we're going to find equal to each other. They are equal, the numbers that are equal to each other. So 5 plus 7, 7 plus 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 12. 6 plus 6 is what? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is equal to this. So now I did this. 17 minus 14. 14 to 17. 14, 15, 16, 17. How many fingers? 3. So they are equal to each other. 11 minus 8. 8, 9, 10, 11, 3. So they are equal to each other. So you write this. 17 minus 14 equals to 11 minus 8. That's how I did. I got this. For before you get the answer, before you know this, I want you to figure out what the answers are first. Then that's where you join the answers together. So here we have 9 plus 4. 9 plus 4. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. You write the numbers. 8 plus 5. 8 plus 5. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So they are equal to each other. So you write these numbers together, you join them together like this for you to get the answer. So here also, you find the other answers. Find the answer here, find the answer here. Then join the numbers that, join the equations, the numbers that have the same answers together. Then you put them together. That's how to find that equal to. And for this particular question, here we are asked to complete by putting in the correct symbol. So here you're going to put in the correct symbol for each of these questions. I answered only two, so I'm going to explain how I got this, and I'll answer two more questions here. So here we have 8 plus 9. 8 plus 9 is what, 17, when you put this together. So here we are asked to put the equal to, less than and greater than. So we find this, we have 17 and 16. Which number is bigger? 17 is bigger. So the elevator will be the bigger number. The mouse is open now. So we have 11 minus 6. 11 minus 6 is 5. And we have 8 here. Which number is bigger? We know that 8 is bigger. So it's going to eat 8. His mouth is open. Okay. Now we have 5 plus 6. 5 plus 6 is what? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So which number is bigger? Which number is bigger here? 13. So where is my alligator going to face? It's going to face the bigger number, which is what? 13. So I'll solve one more, and that's it. So here we have 18 minus 4. What is 18 minus 4? So count on from 4 to 18. Or you count back from 18 to 4. Either way, you can do it either way. So I'll count from 4 to 18. So we go 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Then I'm going to count how many lines I have here. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So I have 14 here. So we have 14 and we have another 14 here. So always solve your answer like, always solve the question like this, write the answer at the top of it, then you can now put that correct symbol. Okay, so here we have 14, here we have another 14. So what am I going to put here? Am I going to put the equal to the less than or the greater than? I'm going to put equal to because they have the same number. So that's how to solve this also. So here, I want you to figure out how to solve this. Think of how to do this. Okay, so here we have, excuse me. So use each of the numbers here. We have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 to fill in the missing number. So I'll put, so here we have dash plus dash is equal to 15. I can put 9 plus 6, 9 plus 6 or 10 plus 5, okay? I can put 9 plus 6, okay, 9 plus 6 is equal to 15 plus, I don't want to use 10 plus 5. So I want to figure out any other numbers I can put. Dash plus dash is greater than 15. I want to think about numbers to put there. Can you find the different ways to complete this? Yes, I want you to figure that out also. And here, click here to play the online game and learn more about this lesson. That's it in our lesson for today. I hope you understood the lesson. And make sure you do your classwork and homework and continue to stay safe. Bye. See you on our next video.